First, I'd like to congratulate Mr. Hawke and the Australian Labour Party on winning this election. I hope they can achieve what they intend for the people of Australia. They've set a high ambition, and I hope they can achieve it. That was yesterday, but today life goes on. No more hiding in yesterday, 'cause yesterday's gone.
I tell you what, any boss who sacks anyone for not turning up to die is a bum.
Spoken gratefully of your wife's forbearance in your earlier exuberant times, would Hazel have had, would you have been happy to extend to Hazel the same sexual freedom as you were able to enjoy?
No. Pass that one.
Anti-personnel carriers and tanks moved in to push the remains into piles, which were then incinerated by troops with flamethrowers.
My love, I gave it all, but I saw the light when I heard you call. Life that we both could share has deserted me, left me in despair. But now I stand alone with my pride, fighting back the tears I never let.
By 1990, no Australian child will be living in poverty.
Let's hear about the greatest environmental policy in the world, and let's see it activated, sir, not radioactivated.
We're sick of your abuse of democracy, my friend. People are here to hear me, not you.
This is a recession that Australia had to have.
I wouldn't have used that form of expression.
That was yesterday.
You looked genuinely sad before when you were talking about the world that our children are coming into. Are you optimistic for the future of the planet?
I am by nature. I have all my life by nature been an optimist, Andrew. But I've got to say that when I look at the facts now in this world, there are not many grounds for optimism. You take the elements. Just take population for a start. Population is exploding. We've got to do something about getting a sustainable population level. And, of course, this gets back to poverty. It gets back to the education of women and so on. We've got the problems of food supply, of global warming, massive increases in population. Now, these are not the figments of Bob Hawke's imagination. These are facts. You've got, over a billion people in the world of over 6 billion now living in absolute poverty, and half the world's population living in very meagre situations.
It seems to be an insurmountable problem, the question of overpopulation and overconsumption, and that we have finite resources and that we're finding more and more ways of using them. What is the hope?
The answer to that question is how are developed nations going to be persuaded of the need for action? I mean, it's how does the message get through? I mean, you look in terms of political leadership. There are no great political leaders around.
We live also in an age of constant distraction, where for a lot of people, what may have happened to Britney Spears last night is far more interesting than...
Yeah. Well, it's, I mean, I don't want to be a media basher, but there's obviously the people who run the media, both public and private, have got an enormous responsibility. I do despair when I see the prioritisation of issues presented by the media. It's, as you say, I mean, I literally cringe whenever I see the name Paris Hilton. Who wants to know about what bloody Paris Hilton's doing when you've got half the world living in, you know, poverty, when you've got the potential for the world blowing itself up?